Hello everyone, and welcome back to Spyro the Dragon, the replay. I am Wishblade, and we are in the Alpine Ridge, where we already got a bunch of treasure, because we landed almost right upon the treasure. Go away, sir. Aha, fall off the side of the world. More wizards. I'ma get ya, you bastards. Go away. Sir, come over here so I can kill you. There you go. Oh, ow. So I was just thinking, me replaying old Let's Plays, would I do that with other games? I'm not sure. I'm not sure I'd redo DLC quests, because, it's not that big of a game, and I don't know. I'm not sure if that really needs a replay. My blind Let's Play on Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. I'll think about it while we free this dragon. Sane!
Spyro, you're not afraid of those big, noisy, gigantic, awful beasts, are you?
Of course not.
I didn't think so.
I'm not scared of anything. Definitely. Clearly. Yeah. But, Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons, would I replay that? I'm not entirely sure. I think it's... That's, I don't know, I feel that's kind of an experience that you have to go through, so I'm not sure it would be the same if I go through that again and I know what's gonna happen and everything. Just, I'm not sure, so I'm not sure if I will. Probably not, so don't expect that. It's highly unlikely. And what else do we have? Replay of Black Rock Mountain? Nah, I don't think so. Doubt I'd do that. Speaking of which, you might be wondering, why would you replay something like that? Well, for the same reason I'm replaying this, because back then, my Let's Plays were not as good. I'm not sure, it wasn't much the video quality and such. Maybe that could have been a little better, probably, but it's mostly the commentary and such. And yeah, I just like things to be proper and good, and yeah, those Let's Plays back then, they definitely could have been much better. Now, something like Star Wars The Old Republic, how would I feel about replaying some of those things? Possibly. Let's free a dragon. Eldred.
Oh, thank you for releasing me.
Long break after what you said. Kinda awkward, silent moment. Really weird. But yeah. Star Wars The Old Republic? Yeah, like... The first half of those, like the first four stories I did, were with my headset microphone, so the commentary on those were kinda meh. The beginning of the fifth one, Jedi Consular, was... Also with the headset, so that was a little bad. And then I got my new microphone and I had to tweak audio levels a bunch with those videos, and that was just really bad, so maybe. And then there were some moments in the other stories where it was a little sometimes I did some messing up and stuff like that, and I do recall the last two episodes of my Bounty Hunter storyline, where apparently my mic, the volume and such, was really low for some reason. I'm not entirely sure why, so I don't know. Maybe I should replay those at some point to redeem them. Hi, Sander.
Great work, Spyro. If you keep this up, you'll learn all the tricks of the magic crafter world.
I definitely will. I've already learned them. I just might not be able to remember them all. Because I'm old and stuff. No, I'm not that old. I think. Kinda. I don't feel that old, so be quiet. Another dragon. So many of them. Kelvin.
Remember that these blue thieves haven't stolen eggs only in the Magic Crafter world. Don't worry, I'll take care of them.
Indeed we will. But yeah, another important factor, something with the potential of replaying Star Wars The Old Republic. Now, like back then, I did it with the 12 times experience boost that was given to subscribers after the 4th of May, which is Star Wars Day, if I'm not mistaken. I'm fairly certain. Yeah, May the 4th be with you. So, yeah. Back then, I did it with that. And now, because of the changes to the leveling and such in Knights of the Fallen Empire, I think now you have the possibility of just doing the class story and the most important missions of the planet you're on. So maybe the leveling experience can be all right that way, and also I'd be able to show off the storylines of the planets themselves. So maybe that would be all right, but I haven't tested if that is actually the case. Like, you can just do class missions and the most important planetary missions, and you'll get easily to the max level that you need for each planet and such, so you won't fall behind and you need to grind, because grinding is something I hate. I hate grinding. That is just bad. Really bad. Let's go to Wizard Peak. Well, not Wizard Peak. Wizard Peak is somewhere else. This is High Caves. Wizard Peak is back at the Balloonist guy, which I didn't talk to, so I don't really know what we need. Maybe I should go back and do that at some point. Maybe. Oh no, it's the gigantic metal bugs. I don't like them. I'm gonna go this way instead. And you guys can just disappear. Disappear into nothingness. So can you. But yeah, so maybe, possibly at some point, maybe I could consider doing that, replaying the stories for Star Wars The Old Republic. Maybe, but nah. It would be something I'd have to think about quite a bit. Also, another thing that could make it a little easier to do, I'll tell you after I free the dragon. Cliffhanger! Cyrus.
Please do something about these green druids. They insist on moving everything in sight.
Why do they want to do that? Do they really like momentum? Maybe they do. I don't know. Maybe they are druids of kinetic energy. Go away, sir. But yeah, another thing about Star Wars The Old Republic. Now you don't have to give your companions gifts and stuff like that, or choose the right options to get all their story missions and such. Now you just get them at certain points in your class story, and you can still give them gifts and such to boost their influence, as it's called now, to make them more effective on stuff like crew missions, where basically crafting and professions and such. Another dragon? Ajax!
I hate those bugs! When I become big and strong, like you, I'll squash them all!
Until then, remember that supercharge makes you invincible.
Indeed it does. And it kills giant metal bugs. It's very powerful like that. But yeah, companion missions and such, they just appear at certain points. Like, you might finish up one planet and then you get two new missions for, like, your first companion. You finish up Drummond Cass and then maybe you get two extra missions for whatever character you're using. So there you go. So that would make things a bit easier and such. And every companion can be whatever you want them to be. They can be DPS, tank, healer, either one. You can set them to whatever. You can set them to whatever you want them to be. So yeah. That makes things a little easier if you're like, oh, I really want to use this companion, but I could really use a healer alongside me. But Yeah, but now you don't have to worry about that. Now you can use whatever companion you want, and that companion can be whatever you want. A tank, healer, DPS. I already said that, but there you go. Repetition. It's very wonderful. Sometimes. And anything else? Also, they don't need gear. So that's a thing. Their stats are increased alongside your levels and such. So, yeah. Everything is just much easier, really. So, yeah, maybe, possibly, I could consider doing that at some point. Maybe. But that'll have to wait until sometime in the future. I'm not entirely sure what games I'll be doing here in the future after Tales of Symphonia. I'm not playing Tales of the Abyss or anything like that. But after Symphonia and Year of the Dragon, I have a feeling of what I might do, but we'll see. I'm not gonna spoil it for you just yet, no. Cedric!
Try combining supercharge with jumping and gliding, and really explore the high caves.
I'll do that. I think I've already done that. Kinda. In a way. Almost. Sorta. Something. Apple pie. Random words are random. Alright, let's see. Yeah, we need to go over there as well. Come, supercharge. You shall send me off into the sky. Lift me up to where I want to be. And I don't know why I keep singing that. Apparently, I don't know if anyone knows if there's some place where that might be from. Lift me up to where I want to be. Then, by all means, do tell me, because I have a feeling it's just a phrase that I've picked up somewhere. I'm not sure. Sometimes I'm like, where did I get that phrase from? I've come to realize the reason why I say delicious is because I've heard Total Biscuit say it in his and Jesse Cox's playthrough, let's play, whatever you want to call it, of Terraria. There's one episode where TB actually says, delicious! So, apparently I stole that from him. I am very evil, clearly. Right, let's kill some bugs. Come here, bug. Die, you bastard. Ow. Damn it, I failed so hard. That is so sad. But anyway, I think we need to go up anyway, so might as well go up high and try to avoid all the baddies. All the unkillable baddies, anyway. Hello, sir. I'm here to kill you. He looked very stoned. He says, what, man? I'm just standing here being all like crazy, man. Hello, fairy. Ooh. I have been kissed and blessed with the power of Super Flame for a certain while. I don't remember how long it lasts, but we'll see how much I can do with it. Oh no, it's depleting. That is so sad. Let's go and get that treasure I didn't collect because I was too busy trying to get to all the others and flame their sorry butts. Like there. And up there. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Thank you. And now let's use the supercharge instead. Because I don't think I can get all the way down to the bottom and kill whatever is hiding down there. So I'll use the supercharge to get down there and then I'll destroy them all. Like so. Run, Spyro. Run. Run fast like something. Maybe the wind, I'm not entirely sure. Yoink. And I believe that is all of them now. Now we just need to get all the treasure. All the remnants of the treasure. The remaining treasure, the stolen treasure. So did Nasty Nork steal all this and just place it all over the place? Place it all over the place, Yeah. Great use of words, Wishblade. It's very wonderful. I don't know where I'm missing treasure. That's a little sad. I guess I'll have to go look around for treasure now. Let's see, I'll just explore the caves a little bit more. And if I don't find the treasure, then I suppose I'll cut to whenever I find it. Because looking around for treasure is a little bit boring. Just a tiny little bit. Yeah, I don't really know. So you know what? I'm gonna cut until I find the treasure. I'll be right back. I believe I found it! Right over here. I totally missed this area. There we go, there we go. And hopefully that is all of it. Right there. There we go, silly me for missing the treasure. Missing an entire little area of treasure. That is almost blasphemy. We can't have this. Wishy, you're so evil. You're so evil and cruel for missing the treasure. It was just lying there, waiting for you. And you abandoned it. Why, oh why, my God above, have you abandoned them? I don't know. If you know what that song is, then I salute you. But now we return home. Our home keeps changing all the time. First it's the artisan home, then it's the peacekeeper's home, then it's the magic crafter's home, and now I want to go and talk to the balloonist. See what he actually wants me to acquire in order to move on. Or I could just run off the edge of the world and die. I could also do that. That is also something I could do. It's very dumb, but I could do it. I could do it. And I did do it, really. Well, I guess we're running back now. Oh. Don't race the ground beneath my feet. I like the ground not moving. Thank you very much. There we go. Let's try this again. Hopefully not dying. Go away, sir. Thank you. And there we go. What do you want, sir? To go, the balloonist. Recovering so many of our dragon eggs. Yeah, but I'm not gonna go there. Apparently it's dragon eggs. And now, where shall I go next? Where shall we go? I do not know. You know what? I think we're gonna go to Wizard Peak. Come, everyone. Oh, go away. Don't try to push me in the water. Spyro doesn't like the water in this game. Or whatever it is. It could be something else, but I'm gonna assume it's water. Just water of some kind. More awesome music. Yeah. Bam, bam, bam. Bam. Oh god, this level. Oh no. Also, yetis of some kind. Nork yetis. They're so scary and mean and menacing. Is there anything hiding over here? Yes, there is. That area right there. That is hiding right over here. You thought you could hide from me, but after missing that other area back there, you shall not hide from me any longer. I will find you, and I will collect all your treasure in the name of something. I'm not sure what, but something. And yeah, there's that platform over there, but I don't want to go over there right now. I'll just get the treasure over here, and hopefully I don't have to fly off somewhere in this general location. Well, I have to fall down, apparently. Go away, thingy. You little mountain goat. Is that a goat? Yeah, I'd assume that's a goat. A wee little mountain goat. In which case, that is very exciting. I like goats. I don't know why, but I do. Hello. Go away, sir. And now we're back here, but I think we actually want to go back here because I don't think there's a swirly over there to take us back up, so we'll have to go over here again. And then we can glide over to the other balcony area and get more treasure. More treasure, more enemies to kill, which gives us treasure. Treasure all over the world. I am so crazy with all the treasure. I can just see it in my mind, some weird picture of a really crazed Spyro just holding a bunch of treasure in his arms like, it's mine, my precious. That would be me. That's me. Go away, sir. Oh, also, you go away. Don't hit me. Thank you. That was very kind of you not to hit me. Apparently, thunder has a charge up. Has a charge time something. A cast time. That's what I'm looking for. Not charge time. I don't know. A cast time. There we go. Anything else? Nope. Clearly not. At least, I don't think so. But now that with all those other balconies and such out of the way, I believe that is all the Trixie treasure. And I avoided your lightning. Lightning thunder. Well, thunder is the sound, so that's more like lightning bolt or something like that. Hello, sir. Jarvis.
Welcome to Wizard Peaks. This is my favorite supercharge spot. Use it to bash those wizards.
Okay, I can do that. Hopefully. Something. More supercharge. Supercharge is wonderful. But I'm not looking forward to a certain level. Yeah, it's still gonna be slight pain in the butt. And jump! Yay! We made it over here. To the Grand Treasure Hoard. And I hear you, thief. I hear you. I hear you, and I know you're here. Hello. Now you die. Again, thank you for not running around behind here. That would be really annoying. Really annoying. Now we have to glide down here. Off we go. To infinity and beyond, and not entirely so. No, go away. Wizard, I want to kill you. I want to kill you. No. Aha, I gotcha. And for my efforts, I was rewarded with a wondrous, wondrous purple gem. It's very beautiful. Exus.
Thank you for releasing me.
You're welcome, I guess. I'm slightly worried right now, actually, because usually in my... Because I live in a apartment complex building stuff, whatever you want to call it. And with that, obviously, sometimes come noises from neighbors, because they might be, I don't know, just having guests or... That was a slight hiccup, I'm sorry. Ugh. Thankfully, I can edit that out because I use Audacity and such, so I can edit my commentary without affecting the game audio. Ha 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 ha! But yeah, neighbors can, of course, like, maybe do some drilling in the walls or just have visitors, and they can be maybe slightly noisy of some kind, maybe. So, usually, I don't like recording in the afternoon because at some point there just might be some really annoying sounds, like some people might be drilling in the walls, or at least I don't like recording in the afternoon on the weekdays, and because on the weekdays in the afternoon and such, it's allowed to do stuff like that and be noisy, like drilling in the walls, and yeah, that's the best example I have. But in the weekends, it's not allowed, so in the weekends I can record whenever, but on a weekday like this, it's still April the 1st, so now you know. I usually dread the possibility of someone starting to drill in the walls, and I'm like, oh man, either I'll have to edit that out in my commentary, or there's just too much of it and I can't really edit it out, so I have to start over, and yeah. So, usually I don't do that, and otherwise only record in the evening or during the weekends, and that was just awesome. Awesome and pathetic at the same time. Wow. Go away, sir. Thank you. Wow. That was amazing. The most amazing egg acquisition ever. Go away. But yeah. Right now it is in the afternoon, it's 2:05, and it is wonderful, and there is no immediate noise, as far as I can tell. But there is a dragon right here. Lucas.
Listen carefully, Spyro. There's a secret area in the artisan home. It is at the waterfall. Try jumping on the stones there.
Artisan home? Waterfall? Sounds good.
I already know about this, but nah. Thank you for telling me. Now, where do I miss treasure? How much do I miss? I don't miss any treasure. I have all the dragons. Oh, okay, I'm done. Never mind. Let's go. Bye. Da, 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 da. I think we'll go to the flight level next. That sounds like a good idea. Yes, yes, yes. Not like you really have a say in things, because I do what I want to do, and I do it the way I want to do it, and stuff. Did I get a butterfly? Yes, I did. How very wonderful. Crystal flight, here I come. That's another thing. Me and Let's Plays, one might wonder, like, why don't you do Let's Plays of recent games, like, maybe something like, I don't know, Firewatch came out, and that's story-based and such. Why didn't you do a Let's Play of that and get all that ad revenue and all that YouTube money and stuff? Well, for one thing, that means I'd have to buy new games as soon as they come out, and I don't really have that much money, so I can't continuously do that. And for the most part, I know I've done a few blind-ish stuff, like Brothers and Wolf Among Us, and some of the Star Wars Old Republic stories were blind, but generally I like to make a let's play of games I actually know where the hell I'm doing. Also, DLC Quest was blind. That is correct. So yeah, and I'm not really much for, because I don't make money off of my videos or anything like that. I just do them for fun. If I somehow could be able to make money off them because I had thousands and thousands of viewers, then awesome. But really, it's not what I'm focusing on. I just want to have fun, play the games that I enjoy, and that's it. So I do some slightly old stuff, like Spyro games, Tales of Symphonia, and some indie games and some Telltale stuff that I enjoy. Yes, there might be other indie games, like, oh, considering I've already done The Last Tinker and DLC Quest and Brothers and stuff, but okay, sure, I'll save my game now that I didn't move away from this fast enough. There you go. Thank you, Fairy, for doing that, I guess. I suppose that's fair enough. I've been recording 3 videos now. Maybe I should take a break, and that's not the level I wanted to go to, because I've already been there. I want to go down here to Blowheart. Not Blowheart, like Budum Budum Heart. Blowhard. The difficulty hard, and it's something as hard like rock hard, rock solid. But yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. There you go. Camera point so I can show people what is coming in the next episode, because thank you very much for watching, and until next time, see you later.